Two major factors that influence behavior are those belonging to individual and those belonging to environment. Those belonging to individual can be divided into two more factors: physiological, that is biological needs such as hunger, thirst, or factors such as pain can affect the behavior. Other one is psychological, like ideas, opinions, and attitudes. The factor belonging to environment is the physical surroundings like family, friends, cultural and social background. Another characteristic of human behavior is individual difference, as each person is different. So if you put 10 people in a similar situation, possibility of them behaving differently is high. Same goes for a group. On the contrary, there is also a considerable degree of similarity in behavior among people. For example, if a particle of dust falls into a person's eye, he or she tries to remove it. This is a universal behavior. The next is, behavior is always purposeful and goal-directed, meaning human behavior is always purposeful and one's actions are always directed towards some goal or the other. There are two categories in it: approach behavior, that is positive goal directed, and avoidance behavior, that is negative goal avoidance. For example, a boy sitting and studying suddenly gets up and takes a glass of water. Here, the goal is to have a glass of water and the purpose is to quench his thirst. On the other hand, a boy is sitting and studying and feels cold. He gets up, switches off the fan. Here, the goal is to switch off the fan and the purpose is to avoid the discomfort of cold. Now coming to the next characteristic. Behavior is changeable to a large extent. As we have seen above, there are a number of factors that influence behavior. In view of this, it is possible to change behavior by modifying these factors. It is this changeability which enables a person to act good or bad in a situation or environment. And also, it enables people to adjust to new environment. Behavior also shows stability. So, though the emphasis has been laid on the possible changes in behavior, it must be mentioned that life is not always full of all sorts of changes. While the behavior changes, at the same time, there is also a certain stability in behavior. It does not change with every change in the environment, nor do all forms of behavior change. Human behavior shows a lot of stability. For example, you may still find your grandmother preferring old ideas and old ways of life, though she is living in an ultra-modern world. The last characteristic is behavior is integrated. As already mentioned above, behavior is influenced by a number of factors and a variety of purposes. Every human being has a physiological, psychological, personal, and social purpose. He or she has also been the subject of different learning experience. In spite of all this, behavior always shows an order and a hierarchy of purposes. Every individual behaves as a total person, and this process of organization of different purposes, different learnings, and different influencing factors results in an integration of behavior. Thus, an individual put in different situations still shows certain characteristic ways and styles of behavior which help us to understand and predict his or her behavior. We often say Ram is a pleasant person, Govind is an unpleasant person, Krishna is a sociable person, and so on. Psychologists use the term personality to describe this process of integration. The greater the degree of integration in a person's behavior, the more effective his or her behavior is likely to be. It can therefore be appreciated that behavior is a complex phenomenon and studying behavior is not an easy task.
If you are interested to join a community of like-minded people, check out the link in the description of our Telegram group. Thank you.